Before we get started, I'd like to invite you to join us Friday at 3 o'clock. It's from 3 to 6. We are having a donation drop-off for the Greater Pittsburgh Food Bank and local food pantries. We will be in the parking lot. You may drive through, drop off a donation. It is a monetary collection, for they cannot accept food donations at this time. So we're taking up a monetary collection for the food banks, that they're able to purchase those boxes that you see, the pre-packed boxes that they distribute to everyone in need. So that is this Friday from 3 to 6, and we hope that you come and join us. God is our rock, the foundation of our spiritual home. We are living stones used to build God's house. Let us come and worship the Lord. Welcome home, people of God. Come to find refuge in the shelter of God's care. Come and sit down, for there is room for everyone in God's house. We come to be nourished by God's word, for we know we are precious in God's sight. We come to give thanks for God's faithful love. Please pray with me. We gather today, O God, our guide and guardian, remembering those who have nurtured us, protected us, and helped us grow. We give you thanks for homes that accept us and affirm us as your precious children. In the shelter of your healing love, fortify us as living stones and build us into a spiritual home where all are welcome. In the name of Christ Jesus, our Savior, we pray. Amen. This is Mother's Day, so we come and honor and acknowledge all the mothers who have been and who are and who will be. The mothers who have borne their own children, and for those who may not have had their own children, but have nurtured the children of others. We thank you. The scriptures explain what a mother is. In Proverbs 31, we're told she is clothed with strength and dignity. She can laugh at the days to come. She speaks with wisdom, and faithful instruction is on her tongue. She watches over the affairs of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children arise and call her blessed. Her husband also, and he praises her. Many women do noble things, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Honor her for all that her hands have done, and let her works bring her praise at the city gates. I lost my mother this week. We buried her on Thursday, and I have written a poem to honor my mother that I would like to read today. It's called See Me in the Hummingbird. See me in the hummingbird against the early sky as you sip your morning coffee and I go fluttering by. Watch me dance this way and that and know that I am free. I'll see the world created that was meant for you and me. See me in the hummingbird as I sip the nectar sweet and remember all the times we spent and shared our special treats. We gathered all out on our porch with ice cream on my face. We'd talk for hours and we'd laugh and share a warm embrace. So see me in the hummingbird as the sun is setting low. For I am happy, there is no pain. I pray that you will know that in my darkest hour I was never left alone. I walked with Jesus to himself and heard, daughter, welcome home. That was for you, Mom. Happy Mother's Day. Would you please pray with me? Dear Father, we approach your throne on behalf of the mothers whom you have entrusted with the care of your most precious little ones. We thank you for creating each mom with a unique combination of gifts and talents. We thank you for the sacrifice of each mom that each mom gives for her children. We thank you for the gift of time mom gives for her kids, whether it's stay-at-home moms, working moms, and moms that have a combination of the two. We thank you for the flexibility of moms, for their tirelessness, their perseverance, and their devotion. We pray you give each mom strength. Help her to see in every mundane task the eternal significance that you place on motherhood. We pray for single moms who must lean solely on you for the fathering of their children. We thank you that your big arms surround children who may never know their earthly father. We also pray for mothers who never had the honor of bearing children, but whose nurturing extends to the many poor and needy who come across the threshold of their lives. We ask you to be the daily bread of tired moms. We ask you to be their living water. We ask you to be their source of spiritual and physical strength, and pray that the same grace that flowed from the Father to the Son to us in salvation will flow from mothers to their children. May each mother find rest in you. Most of all, Lord, on this day in which we honor mothers, may we love and cherish the special women who have borne us, who have nurtured us, and who have prayed for our well-being. May our hearts overflow with gratitude to you, who formed and knitted each one of us in our mother's womb. Amen. That is a prayer from Daniel Darling to the mothers. Now, enjoy this program that is to honor each of the mothers out there as we listen to Donna Alverson as she pays tribute to her mother. Would claim. Today comes from Acts chapter 7, verses 55 through 60. And this is the story of Stephen, as he martyred himself for the glory of God. But filled with the Holy Spirit, he gazed into heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. "Look," he said, "I see the heavens opened and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God." But they covered their ears and with a loud shout all rushed together against him. Then they dragged him out of the city and began to stone him. And the witnesses laid their coats at the feet of a young man named Saul. While they were stoning Stephen, he prayed, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." Then he knelt down and cried out in a loud voice, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." When he had said this, he died. We go to our gospel reading today. The gospel according to John, my favorite chapter in the whole Bible, chapter 14, verses 1 through 14. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go and prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come and take you to myself, so that where I am, you may be also. And you know the place to where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. And you know me, you will know my Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Philip said to him, Lord, show us the Father, and we will be satisfied. Jesus said to him, Have I been with you all this time, Philip, and you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, Show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own. But the Father who dwells in me does his work. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. But if you do not, then believe me because of the works themselves. Very truly I tell you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do, and in fact will do greater works than these, because I am going to the Father. I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If in my name you ask me for anything, I will do it. This is the word of God for the people of God, and thanks be to God. I don't know why, but as I was reading this scripture at the earlier part of the week, a song kept coming into my head, a really annoying song, not a hymn, not an appropriate song for a sermon, but I couldn't get it out of my head and I didn't know why. Show me the way to go home, boom, boom, I'm tired and I wanna go to bed. Every time I read it, that song just kept going through my mind. I kept thinking, God, get this song out of my head, give me a good one. Maybe I thought it was because Jaws has been on not long ago, and they sang that song at sunset as the three of them sat around comparing their battle scars from sharks. And when I hear this, I immediately usually think of that scene. So I don't know why it kept coming to me. But then I read back over the scripture and the song began again, and I understood. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the light. And he tells us in his ministry exactly how to go home. Jesus shows us the way to go home. This is my favorite scripture in the whole Bible. It leads up to the verse in verse 27 when it says, Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you, I do not give as the world gives. So it is chapter 14 where I turn to find comfort and answers when I struggle. And I thought it was very appropriate that this was the scripture this week, after the week with my family of losing my mother. It helped us, it comforted us, and then it was the scripture for this week. But the one scripture, the one verse that really comforts me is verse 3. For it creates in me such a powerful and vivid image that I needed this week. As I go and prepare a place for you, I will come and take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And it helped to know that Jesus came and took my mother by the hand and walked her home to look into the eyes of her Creator. Jesus will take you from that mortal, perishable body, giving you new life a body that is imperishable, and you will walk in the arms of our Lord and Savior. I have imagined this many times and wondered about the day I will experience this. And I do this with excitement and praise to the Lord. That is what we should all be looking for, the day when we will meet the Lord. Will you be welcomed, or will you be judged wanting? Stephen was a disciple of Jesus Christ, and he traveled about the land declaring the gospel of Jesus Christ. There had been many threats against him, and he was told to stop, or he would suffer the consequences, but fear did not keep him from doing what he knew he needed to do, what he knew Jesus would want him to do. He was convinced that Jesus was the Son of God, and he never wavered in that proclamation, even as they stoned him. As they were hitting his body and the stones hitting his head, he looked to the heavens and said, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." Then he knelt down and cried in a loud voice, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." When he had said this, he died. Now Stephen gives us two wonderful examples of faith. The first one is, he knows where he's going. He knows that he will be with his Savior soon. When he saw that Jesus and the Father were standing there waiting to greet him. And these are the same promises that are for each one of us. Jesus made these promises to us several times in the Gospels, and there's one verse that Jesus spoke that most Christians know by heart. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life." When we follow the great commandments and the love of the Lord with all our hearts, mind, soul, and strength, and we love each other in his name, we inherit that wondrous kingdom of God. Second, Stephen asks for forgiveness to be given to those who are throwing the stones. Forgiveness for the ones who are in the act of killing him. They murder him, and yet he prays for them. It's reminiscent of Jesus' last comments from the cross when he said, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they're doing." Forgiveness is something that is very difficult for us at times, yet in these instances we see the one who is the Savior and the one who believes in all his heart in that Savior offer forgiveness for their suffering and their death. All of his teachings are true because Jesus shows us this way, and one day we will see the Father and Son welcoming us home. Jesus beat death and walked this earth after he was buried, and he shows us the way to live and to love as God loves us. And he shows us the way to go home. That's an incredible gift from God. Once our ancestors roamed through this earth thinking they were living their lives according to the Almighty God. But they weren't. Not until Jesus Christ, Emmanuel, the Messiah, came to live with us and show us by example. We hear Peter's voice in his letter to the Christians to help them, in his first letter to the Christians. And he says, "Once you were not a people, but now you are God's people. Once you have not received mercy, but now you have received mercy." We have been granted mercy and forgiveness, and despite all of our sins, all of our shortcomings, we still have the invitation to be God's chosen people, handed out to us, ready for us to reach out and take. This is the good news of the day. Because of the life, the death, and the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, we do not have to live in fear. We do not have to be alone, and we will walk into the outstretched arms of Jesus himself and begin the journey home where the Father waits to welcome us. Our loved ones, the people who may still be mourning, will also be there. The people we may still be mourning will also be there to welcome us. There will be a celebration as yet another child comes home to the Lord. Jesus is the way home. Jesus is the source of life. The light of the world illuminates our path. There is no need for fear, for we are loved, and that love will carry us home. Amen. Now we have many things in which we lift up to the Lord in prayer. I pray that you do not dwell on the things that trouble you, the things that restrict you from the life that you knew. I pray that you find joy and that you rejoice in the name of the Lord as well. So let us go to our Father in prayer. Almighty God, forgiving and loving, we thank you and we praise you for that. For Lord, the things that we have done, the things that we do, we would have a difficult time forgiving anyone. But Lord, you are all powerful and all loving, and you forgive us for everything. And that amazes us, Lord. And we pray to be like you. We pray for the strength that we may offer forgiveness as well to those who have wronged us. So we come to you today and ask that you send your Holy Spirit to this place to flow through this room and in every room of the people who are listening this day and beyond. We pray that your Spirit will open their hearts to be warmed, to accept you, to honor and live according to your word. We see what you've made for us. We see the creation, and we are in awe of what happens around us with all the beauty, with the seasons. And even though this season is different from what we've known, we still thank you for it, Lord, for you know the purpose. You know the reason for everything, Lord. So we praise you for this day, this cold, snowy May day. And we thank you for it. We do come to you with concerns of our heart, and we ask you to be with Elaine Stoops as she mourns the loss of her husband, Larry. We pray for their family and their friends. Lord, help them get through this time and to think of the memories with joy rather than heartbreak. We pray for Christy, who needs you, Lord, for the strokes that she is having. She is so young to be going through this, Lord, so we pray that you will be with her and heal her. Father, we lift up April and her family to you as she lost her brother suddenly. And when it is that sudden, Lord, it is so hard to cope with that loss because you just don't understand. So we pray that the Holy Spirit be with them. We pray that you will give them understanding and comfort that he is with you. So Lord, these things that break our hearts, we thank you for being with us to help us through them. We thank you for family and friends who call and send cards. And we thank you for the memories that we can look back and see the wondrous life that we've had and continue to have. So we praise your name, Lord, even in the midst of the struggle. We praise your name for the beauty and the joy and we praise your name for our Lord Jesus Christ, who taught us how to live and to love and to come back into a deeper relationship with you. And through our Lord Jesus, we are able to pray to you, saying, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses. As we pray, we can forgive the trespasses against us. And lead us not into temptation, Lord, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Now I ask that you maintain this posture of prayer as we listen to the music of Donna Alverson and we pray our private petitions to the Lord.
Give me
We come to the Lord who has given us all good things, so that we may return a portion of what has been given to us. We may give thanks and praise the Lord, and we may do the ministry that Jesus Christ has left us to do. So I ask that you continue your faithfulness. I thank God for each one of you for the outpouring of offerings that have come into the church. The church is able to survive because of you. We thank God for the gifts that have been given, and we praise his name because you truly are faithful. If you would like to send in an offering, I ask that you mail it to Greenock United Methodist Church, 1213 Greenock, Buena Vista Road, McKeesport, PA, 15135. So let us come into prayer to our Lord. O God, our fortress and our rock, may these offerings be acceptable to you. In a world facing profound need this day, these may seem insignificant, but we know in your hands, even small things become great. Use these gifts. Use our very lives to make this world a home where all are sheltered, nourished, and cherished. Amen. Our service comes to a close. I hope that you are all well and pray that we will meet again next week. If you would like, you may join me daily at 11 o'clock live on Facebook. It is open to the public. We do morning devotions there together. So please join us, and we'll see you next week here at the same time. But until then, receive this benediction. Once we were not a people, but now we are God's people as his face shines upon us and his faithful love saves us. And the news that is so good for us, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, will lead us on to a life of eternity, of paradise, and of love. Amen.